This
I'll start
conference
off
will now be recorded.
with the introduction of myself. Okay. So I did my engineering, from computer science, and then I went on to do MBA, in marketing and operations. I have around till date of experience of 8 years, out of which 7 years I have experience into SAP TM module. Okay, and along with SAP TM, I have also worked with other modules such as CRM, FI and PI and ECC and different kind of modules which we usually use to work along with, which can be used as an integrator to TM. Okay, so by far I have worked into TM 9.1 version and 9.5 version as well. Okay, currently I am working into SAP TM embedded system in the HANA. Okay, I worked with different client partners, like for the actual implementation with the DHL panel in our nodes. I have worked on two implementation and three rollouts. Okay, and one migration project. So it was kind of an wholesome activity that I have performed with SAP TM. Okay, so before moving ahead, I would just like to know something more about yourself, your background and your profile. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, what's that?
See, I have overall 12 years of experience, okay, out of which I have 8 years of experience in the HR, and I have close to 3.5 years of experience into the SAP SDU module.
Okay. So how did you got up into TM? They're just asking.
My brother recommend me to take this TM.
Okay. So that's a good course. Actually, I would like to tell you it is one of the good course that TM that SAP has came out with. I think it will be a beneficial course for you. Okay, so by far, what I'll tell you the kind of contents that will be covered in the course is I'll start off with the shipping and logistics terminologies. I think whatever I have heard from you, you don't have a logistics background, right?
Yeah.
Right. So then I'll start off with the shipping and logistic terminologies, okay, and then slowly I'll move on with the overview of SAP TM and different kind of scenarios. I'll definitely go on with each end content at the end of the slide, okay. I'll show you what kind of contents that I'll be basically covering. Okay, this is just a high level view that complete air and ocean scenarios, okay, with on system experience that I'll tell you. The main focus will always be on the order management, charge management. Okay, so these are the yeah.
No, I'm sorry to interrupt. I'm also interested in this embedded TM. So
So actually, embedded TM, I think it was not. Sana told me it was not for embedded TM. It was for 9.5. Definitely, I can brief you about SAP embedded TM system that we are currently using in the HANA. But I think this course would be mainly focusing on SAP 9.5
what is the difference in
of TM.
Okay, what is the difference between this 9.5 and the embedded one?
Right. I would just like to tell you about the same that actually what TM came out with the 9.5 version, and then they slowly came out with the 9.6 version. But alongside, they also roll out the HANA functionality in the embedded TM module. Okay. So what currently successful model is 9.5. Okay. After that, they came along with embedded TM in the HANA system. Whatever we have in SAP TM 9.5, everything is there in 9.
Hello. Hello, Apurva. Hello, Apurva. Can you hear me? Sana. Hello. Sana, are you there?
Hi, yes.
Year or 2 year of experience to see and to analyze whether the system is stable, whether it is responding.
I'm not able to hear your voice. You were talking about the difference between the embedded and the SAP 9.5.
Okay,
I'm not able to hear you clearly. If you start after that's.
Okay. So am I audible now or it is still disturbing?
No, it's fine.
Okay, I was just talking about that SAP came out with the 9.5 version and soon they came out with 9.6 version. Okay, but that 9.6 version was not stable and alongside they also launched embedded TM HANA system. Okay, so major focus of the market move toward HANA system. So currently we will not talk about 9.6 system because that is just a simple release by SAP system, and then alongside they also launched up with the HANA system. So whatever we have in SAP TM 9.5 system, you will find the same contents in the HANA system except the Fiori UI, okay, except the HANA functionality that you are going to see once you are into this. So other than that, functionality wise, it will be same as TM 9.5 system because TM 9.5 system is much more stable and it is also implemented by the users and reviews are also good. Okay, so that's why and in the HANA system, the clients are still implementing. Okay, after implementation, they will take a year or so for the particular review and what kind of drawbacks they are getting from the HANA system. Okay, so that's what I would like to tell you, that if you are going for embedded TM system, for now you should not go for HANA system because it is not yet being proven. Okay, and 9.5 is proven, it is stable, it is being accepted by the clients as well. So that's what I have seen, that's what I have experienced. So I was just asking you the same. Did I answer you?
Yeah, fine.
Okay, so after that it will be more of a practical session. Okay, I'll be covering majorly on the practical part, creating orders and different kind of things. Okay, theoretical part, since I'll have to begin with the logistics and shipping terminologies, I'll have to introduce few terms. Okay, so basic first two or three classes I'll be taking more on a theoretical basis, and after that we'll be jumping off into the practical aspect. Okay.
Yeah, fine.
Okay. So let us go and see about the two things that we are going to cover in this session, the logistics industry and SAP TM introduction. Okay, so there are two pictures here, transport and logistics. Could you please tell me the difference? How would you differentiate transport and logistics?
Transport, it's a mode of thing where it's kind of a vehicle carrier, what we are planning to carry the goods, Logistics is the one which we plan the volume of the goods, how we transfer. So from place to place, from margin to the end customer. So entire thing will be covered in logistics.
Okay, that was a good comeback, but I would like to tell you that transport is whatever we are seeing here is basically a simple mode or convenience that we use. Okay, be it an airplane, be it a ship, be it any roadways, okay, car, train, bus, anything that you are using, these are just means. What a logistics is a bigger class where transport is just a subset of the particular logistics. Okay, logistics involves each and everything, okay, starting from the packaging, starting from defining the routes, warehouse management, okay, defining the mode of transport, each and everything, whatever you can see, whatever you can feel about the things which are connected to the transportation of a particular business or particular package, that comes into logistics. And the transport is only the medium, okay, or the means you are transporting the goods from place A to place B. That's a simple thing. Okay, so what is transportation? It is simply moving products or material from one place to another, point A to point B. Transportation jobs gets over. What is logistics? It includes the packaging of products, okay, which involves material flow, okay, handling of the particular package, production, inventory management, transportation. You see, it is just a part of the particular logistics operation, okay, and warehousing. And if you are transporting a particular important goods, suppose, then security as well or insurance as well. Okay, then I would like to make you aware about these two terminologies, about the inbound and outbound logistics, if you are aware. Suppose, let me just take an example. Okay, what do you mean by inbound logistics? Okay, suppose you are into a car manufacturing plant. Okay, so what the particular car manufacturing plant does? Yeah, Vasant.
Yeah, Kurwa, you please go in. I'm just listening to your things.
Okay. Okay. So what a particular car manufacturing plant does, they do not manufacture the particular glass, okay, they do not manufacture particular steel, okay. What they does is they procure the raw materials or the finished goods which can act as a raw material for their particular car, okay. So those procurement of materials are called as inbound logistics, which can act as a basic material for building your object. Okay, so suppose you will send a particular measure for a glass, okay, steel, of this kind of steel, okay, I want my car to be of this composition, okay. So the goods will be inbound to your car manufacturing plant. So this kind of logistics where you are importing the finished goods, okay, from the particular source, such kind of logistics is called inbound logistics, okay. And when you are processing those inbound logistics material, okay, you are processing that particular glass, particular steel, you are shaping the particular things into your requirement, okay. Now you are making a particular finished goods, which is a car, okay, is end usable product, okay. Then you will transport that particular car to the dealer, okay. That kind of logistics is called as an outbound logistics.
There, you need to say the inbound and outbound, the difference is that inbound means semi-finished goods and outbound is full-finished full finished goods, right?
In a broader sense, yes, but inbound goods that you are receiving at the car manufacturing plant also, they are also finished, right? If you are ordering 100 windshield glasses of Maruti Zen, okay, so you will get those particular finished goods only. But it is a job of a particular car manufacturer company or car manufacturing plant to use those glasses. So those are also finished good, but from a different perspective. But you cannot use those particular glasses, give those particular glasses to the end user, right? If I am buying a car, that particular glass is of not much worth for me, right? I only demand a particular car from a particular dealer, right? So that particular glass is also finished, but it is not of much use to the end user. Okay, so whatever the products which goes to the end user from a particular plant, that kind of logistics is called as an outbound logistics. Getting delivering a car from to the dealer, okay, that kind of transportation, that kind of logistics, that kind of movement is called as the outbound logistics. But whatever the materials that you are procuring from those particular vendors to your car manufacturing plant and you are assembling them, those kind of procurement, those kind of logistics movement from particular vendor to the car manufacturing plant, that is called an inbound logistics. Does it seem okay?
Yeah, fine up.
Okay. Yeah. So that was just a simple logistics that I covered up. Okay, simple terms. So what is SAP TM? Okay. SAP TM is the transportation management system. Okay. That is designed to manage all the aspects of transportation, okay, processes, those processes within your company, okay, and which includes transportation planning, optimizing, tendering, okay, the charge management that I was talking about, okay. So SAP team covers the full range of modes of transport: air, ocean, rail, and road. Because in the previous version before 9.0, okay, we were not able to cater the air and ocean scenarios. But after 9.0, air, ocean, rail, and road, all four type of scenarios are covered by those 9-point series TM versions. Okay, and it is designed for both shipper and logistics LSP scenarios, logistics service provider. I'll take you into more detail when you'll enroll the session. Okay, I'll explain you each and everything on the same. Okay, so this is a brief about SAP TM. Okay, so why only SAP TM? Why TM? There are multiple products in the market, right? So since SAP TM is one of the pioneering products from SAP, which can cater the transportation management system. Okay, we also have products from different ERP solutions such as Salesforce or Oracle. We do have different kind of TMS products as well, but TM was one of the pioneering product which was actually built upon the experience of DHL and Panalpina's experience, because DHL was one of the pioneering company which started off. And with they came up to SAP and they asked for a particular solution to their particular organization. Okay, you can say that whatever the development that has happened from the SAP side is because of DHL's experience. Okay, this is one of the pioneering company. Okay, so whatever they required, they came up with a particular solution. Okay, and after that, SAP came up with SAP TM version, okay, and then they started off selling the particular product. Okay, so yeah, this question, SAPTM is a successful product or not? Yes, considering the market that we are having in the shipping logistics industry, this is one of the successful product that we are having. Okay, so no doubt in that. And yes, earlier it SAPTM was not able to connect to different kind of systems. SAPTM was only able to connect with other SAP systems only. Okay, so but with time and progress, you can still connect the legacy system or your existing system with the SAPTM system. Okay, so yes, you can still connect with different type of SAP modules, even to other ERP solutions modules, okay, or to your legacy or existing system. Okay, and yes, talking about the career prospects, definitely as SAP consultant, you do have a good career if you have the SAPTM module as a core module or a basic module, because there are very less or few consultants for TM in the market, and considering the shipping scenarios that we are having. Okay, so career prospects are very, very wide. Okay, but yes, considering the overall market growth, okay, so you may not see much TM consultants, but if you look about the shipping industry, most of the people do want TM consultants. Okay, so this was brief about what I would like to say. Simple logistics industry and SAPTM. Yeah, and I would like to take you through the course content. Okay, are you able to see my screen?
Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, I will take you through the essential terms of logistics industry, 3PL and other kind of PL systems. Okay, then we'll go on with the transportation management and the history and how it got evolved. Okay, then we'll go on with the shipper and LSP scenario. Okay, then I'll take you with the FTL, LTL, LCL, FCL. Okay, these are the full container load, less than container load. LTL and FTL are kind of now, if you talk about current scenario, LTL and FTL scenarios are now removed. These are full truckload or less than truckload, because they are replaced by a particular freight order. Okay, that I'll also talk to you about. Okay, I'll talk to you about this SAPTM integration, ECC integration. Okay, what is DTR and OTRs? System terms like FWO, FO, FU, FRB, forwarding order, freight order, freight unit, freight booking. Okay, for ocean scenarios, we have LCL, FCL, then the air scenarios. And finally, I'll walk you through the charge calculation and settlement document creation. Okay, so it will be kind of an end-to-end solution for you. Okay, and I'll be delivering the complete content online. Okay, like this only. And the approximated
hello,
yeah.
What about the integration with the other modules, Apurva?
Yeah, I have so far covered SAPTM and ECC integration. You can definitely, depending on the actual project requirement, you can definitely connect the particular TM module to other objects. Okay. But that content will not be covered here.
Okay,
so because TM is basically connected to ECC system, that's what we have seen as of so far, because ECC system is the main financial core system, right? Whatever the billing and invoicing that you are doing, TM that moves out to the ECC or FI system. So that particular integration part that I'll definitely tell you about, but different integration that if you are using a PI, if you are using different kind of integrator, so that actually depends on the project requirement. Okay, So this is all from my end. If you have any questions, doubts, you can come up. If you have further queries, you can ask.
Okay, Apurva, thanks for the demo. But please let me know what would be the duration, approximate duration, in a daily basis if you take the session.
It will be kind of 1.5 hour session. I think that would be fine. It can be alternate days or more on the weekend part. I can take up 2 to 3 hours in weekdays weekends. So the we can decide upon that once you are okay with the delivery content.
Okay, then how about the practical session? So will be followed in parallel, or will it be we used to work on the weekends?
No, it will be followed parallelly. Okay, so just how can the right away, right? I'm sharing my screen and I'll taking you through each and every stuff. So similarly, I'll be taking you to the SAP screens. Okay, and I'll be demonstrating you each and every cases scenarios. Okay, so it will be like that.
Okay.
Then definitely you will be having the
Apurva, on what
login.
operating system? Hello?
Yeah, hello. Yeah.
How good are in embedded systems?
I'll be explaining you the all the concepts in 9.5. Okay. So once you are into the embedded system, you basically have a Fiori system, right? You have heard about Fiori, right? Fiori UI. So what it is basically, essentially shows you the only the important picture. Right, it will give you the shipper or the consignee. The major part will be hidden. Okay, since Fiori UI is launched for a user simplification. Okay, so the kind of contents that you'll be able to see, the kind of buttons, kind of screens that you'll be able to see 9.5 in HANA or embedded TM system, those kind of things will not be there because there you'll be having a Fiori UI. Okay, so it will be a much more simpler screen in the Fiori. So I think it would be better if you go with the 9.5. You learn those concepts, you learn those things there, and then definitely when you are practically implementing in your organization, you can go ahead and with the Fiori UI system. Those things you will be understanding. Okay, this thing is coming from there. There we used to create such things. Now you are not seeing this. You are just able to view the particular one label. Okay, so it is just in what I can say, simple application. Okay, which Fiori has came up to. I'm not able to get to the correct words, but embedded TM system is much more simplified version where you will not get much detailing of the particular system. So it would be better if you go with the stable system 9.5. You learn the concepts, you learn the things there, and then definitely you can go on with the easier way, like HANA.
Okay. So Apurva, you are from which part?
Which part means?
Which city?
Okay, I am located in Pune.
Okay.
So
See,
the server details will
I
be
take
provided.
the expectation from my side. Okay, so I just want to make it clear the day one itself. Okay. See, the thing is, we don't have much time to spend, and we don't want to drag it for a long time. Okay, so I just want to learn it as soon as possible and as early as
Sure.
possible. Okay.
Sure,
So I need your
that's why.
support. See, even in a day, if we plan half hour for a regular session and a half an hour for a practical session is also fine for me. But anything, I need to complete this entire course as soon as possible. Okay, so if it is possible for you to complete this session in 15-20 days is also fine, but we can later we can have a discussion, one-on-one discussion, and
Definitely,
I
that's
have a
yeah,
doubt.
definitely, definitely. That's why I have kept this as approximated hour, because depending on the kind of person, actually, I'll definitely cover up. I'll take most of the things. Okay, so it is not a kind of approximated hour. It is kind of depending on you. If you want to cover it as soon as possible, I'll try to finish it off with your prospect only. So
Yeah, see,
don't worry.
I'm available to keep the session for day long. Okay, so I don't see. I'm full-fledged available to take the sessions at any point in time at any schedule. Okay,
Okay.
so even we can connect twice in a day. So it's not a problem for me. We can connect and we can have a discussion. So it's not going to be a challenging part for me, because anything I just want to complete as soon as possible, because I have very short
Okay.
deadline to complete this session.
No issues, no issues. I think by if you are going by this way, I think I'm also available. So I think we will be able to complete it much faster, because this is a long holiday season, right?
Yeah, that's what.
So
See,
yeah.
before this vacation, because I took a vacation now,
Right.
so I just want to complete in this 15 days of
Right.
so
Right,
I
right.
be more comfortable for me to sit in a day-long session also.
Okay, that would be fine. No issues, no issues from my side. I'll start and I can start as soon as possible, and I'll finish it off based upon your convenience. No issues. I can take 4-5 hours. No issues.
Yeah, okay. So what about the next things, Apurva? How
Yeah, okay. For yeah, once she's you are done with Sana about the kind of what kind of payment that you are about to make.
Hello, sorry for interrupting you.
Yeah, Sana, one second.
Vasant, I Dipali here actually. Sana ma'am will coordinate with you regarding this training. She will call you or email you regarding it. Vasant, can you hear me?
One second, Sana, one second. Hold on a minute.
Dipali here, actually behalf of Sana ma'am, I handle today's session. Sana ma'am will coordinate with you regarding this training. Other she will call you.
Okay. Please ask her to
Okay.
call me as soon as possible, because we have to take a call on
Yeah,
this one.
he. Yes, sure, definitely.
Okay then, Vasant. Okay, Dipali. Then I think we can sign off.
Yeah, thanks,
Yes,
Apurva.
sure. Thank you, Apurva. Thank you, Vasant.